are in your presence. Fiercely the power inside of me. You're the living water, never drying fountain, comforter and counselor, take control. Welcome, Holy Spirit, we are in your presence. Fills with your power, live inside of me.
Is worth living because he lives. Amen. Good to see you tonight in the house of the Lord, and good to see a lot of good smiling faces, and good to see Johnny tonight. I love you, Johnny. Johnny, I'm glad he had the strength to come tonight. I know how he feels. I've been where he's at. You know, you don't ever know that until you've been there, do you? And so, but I'm so glad to see Johnny and Michelle back there, and all of you here tonight. God is so good to us, and Jenny and her husband back there tonight. We love y'all. God answered a prayer, didn't he? God answered a prayer. I was talking to Billy this week, and remember a couple of weeks ago, I'm careful when I say things like this, but we prayed a specific prayer for her not to have MS, and she has no MS. I wish God would give God praise. And thanks for that tonight. Isn't God good? Isn't God good? He's so good. Amen. Give God praise. Give God praise. God is so good. I love to hear good news, don't you? Amen. I'm blessed tonight. In just a few minutes, my son will be stepping to the pulpit. I'd rather know that than him being a heart doctor and fixing to take somebody's heart out of their body and work on it, to know that in just a few minutes, my son's stepping to the pulpit to preach tonight. We're blessed, aren't we? We're just blessed people. Amen. Let's go ahead and receive our offering for tonight, if you would. And ushers, would you come, please, and receive that our Sunday night offerings. I appreciate you being generous and kind in your offerings. The Lord knows all of our needs. And now I'm going to be talking to you tonight. One of the best, I've been reading it over and over for myself. I'm going to be preaching out of Psalms 84 and 11 tonight. For the Lord God is a sun and a shield, and the Lord will give grace and glory, and no good thing. Boy, I'm telling you, that gets me right there. No good thing will he withhold from them that walk uprightly. Wow. And so tonight when you give, God's, and I want you to start in your hearts already asking, what good thing do I need tonight? What good thing do I need from God? And God will grant it. Amen. Amen. Pray for us, Chris.
Oh, sing it, church. He's already here. Welcome, Holy Spirit. We are in your presence. Fill us with your power. Live inside of me. Sing it again. Welcome, Holy Spirit. Welcome, Holy Spirit.
I will enter his courts with praise.
you fellowship with your neighbors for a minute and sing, He has made me glad. Yes, He has made me glad. I will rejoice, for He has made me glad, so glad. He has made me glad. Yes, He has made me glad. I will rejoice, for He has made me glad. His gates with thanksgiving in my heart. I will enter His courts with praise. I will say, this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice, for He has made me glad. Sing it out. He has made me glad. Yes, He has made me glad. I will rejoice, for glad, so glad. He has made me glad. Yes, He has made me glad. I will rejoice, for He has made me glad. One more time. He has made me glad. Yes, He has made me glad. I will rejoice, for He has made me glad, so glad. He has made me glad. Yes, He has made me glad. I will rejoice, for He has made me glad. Hallelujah. Offer up praise to the Lord tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Offer up the praise that He is worthy. Hallelujah. We sang this song this morning, and I've just been basking in the presence of the Lord through this song all afternoon. It just simply says, Holy Spirit, rain down. And I'm so thankful for His Spirit. Amen. Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, rain down, let your power fall, let your voice be heard, come and change our hearts as we stand on your word. Holy Spirit, rain down, sing that again. Holy Spirit, rain down, oh Comforter and Friend, how we need your touch again. Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, rain down. No eye has seen, no eye has seen, no ear has heard, no mind can know what God has in store. So open up heaven, open it wide over your church. Holy Spirit in our lives tonight. Are you hungry for Him to rain down? Let's sing it. Holy Spirit, rain down, rain down. Oh, Comforter and Friend, how we need your touch. for the goodness of God. A flat. Hallelujah. Oh, Father, we just wait on you tonight. Oh, Holy Spirit, we just wait on you tonight. We just wait on you. Hallelujah. No eye has seen, no ear has heard, no mind can know what God has in store. So open up heaven, open it wide over your church and over our lives. Holy Spirit, rain down. No eye has seen, no eye has seen, no ear has heard. Let's just worship him. Hallelujah. Oh, we thank you, Lord, for your presence. Rain down. You're our comforter and friend. Oh, how we need your touch again. Holy Spirit, rain.
Till I lay my head.
the goodness of God. Testify to that. Hallelujah. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. Oh, I'm gonna sing the goodness of God. One more time, all my life. Hallelujah. All my life you have been. Oh, he's been faithful to you. Amen. Thank you, Lord. All my life you have been so,
so good.
With every breath
that I am able, sing of the goodness of God.
I
will sing of the goodness of God.
Oh, can you praise Hallelujah. Him for his faithfulness?
Thank
tonight.
God for his goodness.
Hallelujah. If you are in
Thank
this
God
house,
for his
you
goodness.
Are walking, standing, breathing testimony
Hallelujah.
Of his faithfulness.
Yes.
Amen. All the times that the enemy
Hallelujah.
Tried to take you,
you
out, all those close calls,
yes.
all those nights when you were laying in your
Thank
sin,
you,
all those days when you walked in shame, all those times when you knew you were doing wrong, when you knew you were bound for hell, and yet your goodness is running after. It was
running after me.
Goodness is running after.
It's running after me.
With my life laid down,
I surrender now.
I give you everything.
Your goodness is running after. Running after me. All my life you have been faithful.
Aren't you glad he never gave up? Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
So good with every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. I will sing of the goodness of God. Before you're seated tonight, would you praise him for his goodness and his mercy? Hallelujah. That all my life, all my life you've been faithful. Hallelujah. All my life you've been faithful. The goodness of God. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. I will sing of the goodness of God. Amen. Give him loud praise one more time. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Understand what I'm fixing to say, but you know, we're kind of a diamond in the rough in Cleveland. If people knew how we love to worship God, you know, a lot of churches don't have church on Sunday night, and we see some of them coming in. I believe there's hungry people for Sunday night church. Does anybody really believe that? I believe there's hungry people for Sunday night church. And I love the worship and the singing. And we're just blessed, aren't we? We're just a blessed group of people. Addie came to me tonight for service. And I meant for her to sing earlier, but I'm going to let her come on tonight because God reminded me of something I was sitting there saying. Now, what should I do? But do you know some of the greatest revivals that's been started have been started in children? Have been started in children. Who knows? She might sing this song tonight that she's going to sing. Come on up, Addie. What's the name of it? He's a Waymaker. Oh, my goodness. She's going to sing He's a Waymaker tonight. Won't you help her sing it tonight? Why don't you just help her sing it? You got it ready? Amen. Won't you help her sing it? Will that thing go real loud? Turn that thing up.
Darkness, my God, that is who you are.
Somebody give him praise tonight. He's the way maker. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Is anybody glad he makes ways where there seemeth? Don't even seem to be a way. God makes ways out of no ways, opens doors that no man can close, and closes doors that no man can open. He's a way maker. Won't you give him praise one more time tonight? Amen. Thank you, Lord. I'm excited to preach this word. I'm always excited to preach the word, but I believe God is going to do some good things in this place tonight. I just believe God is going to do some good things in this place tonight. If he don't, guess what? And God's not a liar, is he? He's not a liar. He can't lie. He can't lie. Does anybody need any good things in your life tonight? Does anybody need any good things? Well, I want to talk about that tonight. Psalms 84, if you would turn in your Bibles. Psalms 84, I'm going to be reading two verses, verses 11 and 12. I don't know if I told you both verses or not, Brother Danny, but I'm going to be reading both verses 11 and 12. Psalms 84, verse 11 and 12. I want you to grab hold of this tonight. I really want you to grab hold of what I'm fixing to tell you. Because you can take it word for word. You can take it, it's for you. You can take this personal. You can make it personally for you tonight. For the Lord God is a sun and shield. And the Lord will give grace and glory. No good thing will he withhold from them that walk up. That's conditional, isn't it? That's a conditional statement. No good thing will he withhold from them that walk uprightly. O Lord of hosts, blessed is the man that trusteth in thee. Father in heaven, I thank you tonight for your word. What a word. What a promise. What a hope that we have that you will not withhold any good thing from those who walk uprightly. And God, I praise you for tonight, that tonight. And I pray when we leave this place tonight, that people will grab hold of the good things that God has for them. And I will praise you and I will give you glory. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen. Before I begin tonight, let me just remind you what I've already said. It's conditional what I'm fixing to preach tonight. It's conditional. I think God is tired of people thinking that he has to give them everything they need when they don't even serve him. I believe God's fed up with that. People don't even serve God, but yet they believe God should give him all the good things. Well, I believe this is a conditional verse in the Bible, that if you walk uprightly, God will not withhold any good thing from you. And let me also say this before I begin tonight. Let me start by saying that sometimes he will withhold something that you think is good, but actually it wasn't good for you. Does anybody know what I'm talking about? We think it's good for us and we really want it, but he withholds it from us because he knows that it's not good for us. And there's the problem. Sometimes when he does that, we act like kids throwing a tantrum. I heard a few oohs or something back there a while ago. But we act like kids throwing a tantrum. I believe tantrums need to be picked up and dusted on the bottom. Does anybody know what I'm talking about? I have a nervous condition about kids that's always throwing tantrums. What they need is to be picked up and their bottom busted. Amen. And sometimes God might just do that to us. Because we're throwing a fit over what he didn't give us when he knew it was best not to give it to us in the first place. So it's conditional, and sometimes he withholds what we think is good because he knows it's not good for us, but we really think it is. But I'm here tonight to tell you that if you walk uprightly with God and you really serve him with all of your heart, I can promise you tonight that he will not withhold any good thing that he thinks is good from your life and your family. Amen. Hallelujah. I want to talk to you about a few things tonight. Why does he tell us that? Why does he promise to supply all of our needs? I want to tell you tonight that God will do that because he is our Father. Oh my goodness, when I get to thinking about that he's my Father, hallelujah, that God will provide because he is your caring Father. When we put all of our trust and faith to Jesus to save us, not only does he wash away our sins, but he adopts us into the very family of God, and we become his children. Hallelujah. In fact, Ephesians chapter 1 and verse 5, having predestinated unto the adoption of children by Jesus Christ himself, according to the good pleasure of his will. Is anybody glad tonight that he is your Father? Wow. I can't even get over that. I could just shout right there for the rest of this service. Knowing that he's my Father, that he's adopted every believer, and he makes him his very own son and daughter. Hallelujah. And as our Father, he cares about his children. You see, if you care about your own children, if you care about your children and would do anything that you could to provide for them, how much more will God provide for his children? Amen. If you love your child like I do, there's nothing except what they didn't need or what I didn't think was good. There's nothing that I wouldn't do for them. Oh my goodness, get a hold of that. There's nothing that I wouldn't do for my son. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because he's my Father and you can trust God. Not only that, I love this one right here. Did you know he likes to give gifts? That excited a few of you. You must not like gifts like I like gifts. I like gifts, don't you? Opening up, wondering what it is. But he gives good gifts. I've always loved to give gifts to my son. And I loved to make him happy when I could. And now I've got that beautiful daughter-in-law. And she gave us two beautiful grandkids. And oh, how it's just something to be able to give those grandbabies presents. Amen. Oh my goodness. They're expensive. I'm telling you, grandkids are expensive. Yeah. But I love it when I reach Kingsport and they know that Papa and Gran's got something in that truck for them. They know that we got them a present. And here they come running. Sometimes they don't even say hi or nothing. Where is my prize? Where is my present? Because I love to do that for them. And Jesus said that our Heavenly Father delights to give good gifts. Amen. Oh my goodness. To give good gifts to his children. Matthew 7 and 11, the Bible says this. If ye being evil know how to give good gifts unto your children, how much more? You ain't shouting like I thought you'd shout tonight. How much more shall your Father, which is in heaven, give good things to them that ask him? Oh, my goodness. Hallelujah. So our Father in heaven gives good things to us when we ask him. In fact, it is our Father's good pleasure. He loves it. He wants to give us those gifts. James 1 and 17, the Bible said, for every good gift and every perfect gift is from above and cometh down from the Father of lights, with whom there's no variableness, neither shadow of turning. Our Father is a gift giver. Hallelujah. I said our Father is a gift giver. And we can be 100% confident that God will take care of all of our needs. You know why? Because he's already given us the greatest gift. Did you hear what I said? He's already given us the greatest gift. The greatest gift that God has given us is his Son, Jesus Christ. That's how much that God loved the world and how much he loves us, that he gave his Son to suffer the wrath and pay for our sins, that he would forgive us and save us and bring us to himself. So let me ask you this. So would God hold back our daily bread from us when he's already given us his precious son? It ain't nothing for him to give us bread. Did you hear what I said? It ain't nothing for him to give us bread. So why in the world do we think that he would hold back those things that we need when he's already given us the greatest sacrifice, and it's his son? Would God keep things from us or fail to provide us anything else that we truly need? God reminded his people in Psalms 81 and 10 when he said, I am the Lord thy God which brought thee out of the land of Egypt. And I love this right here. Open thy mouth wide. Amen. There's been a lot of prosperity preachers that's messed this up over the years. Amen. What I'm preaching tonight's been messed up over the years by prosperity preachers. And we failed to lay hold of what God really wants for us. Amen. I want you to get that. I am the Lord that brought thee out of the land of Egypt. Open thy mouth wide, and I will fill it. My goodness. God essentially said, if I rescued you from slavery in Egypt, which you could never have saved yourself from, don't you think that I will meet all the other needs in your life? Open your mouth wide. Yes. Oh, my goodness. Open your mouth wide. Ask me for the big things. Ask me to meet your needs, and I will fill it. I did the big thing, and surely I'll take care of the lesser things, like putting bread on your table and clothes on your back. Amen. Hallelujah. How many know that God did do the big thing for us? He saved us from our sin and our wrath. He gave us eternal life. He made us his children. So ask him for your provision. He'll surely take care of all of our needs. For God, if God gave his son, you can be sure that God will provide your needs in your life. Oh, what a promise. What a promise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Not only that, but God provides because he's our shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. What'd you just say? I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. Green pastures speak of abundant provision. Jesus cares for his flock, and he cares for every one of his sheep individually. Did you hear what I said? Individually. It's not just a flock mentality. It's not just a flock mentality, but he cares for you individually. How many know that sometimes he'll even leave the flock and go after the one? Because it's an individual thing. Sometimes when you're straying and he knows that you're going to get in trouble and he knows the wolf is near, but you're wanting to play on the outskirts. How many glad it's just not a flock mentality, but he'll walk out and he'll pick you up and he'll bring you back to where you need to be. Does anybody know what I'm talking about? Because he's the good shepherd and he cares for his sheep. Hallelujah. 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 Psalms 23 and 5 says, you prepare a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Amen. And even though we're surrounded by spiritual and times physical enemies, our wonderful host prepares a table for us. Yes, obviously, that's a spiritual feast. Yes. But he certainly provides for us materially as well. And David expresses his confidence in the Lord's provision when he says this, that surely goodness and mercy will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Somebody praise him tonight that you're one of his sheep. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. I did a study one time, and it's amazing, and I don't want to get off much what I'm talking about tonight, but talking about the sheep, I've read where that if a sheep wanted to just keep on straying, that sometimes that shepherd would deliberately break his leg. So he can't go. He knows he's better off with that broke leg close to him than he is out wandering where the wolves are. Has anybody ever had your leg broke? You probably haven't, didn't even know it. Amen. You probably didn't even realize it. But God will break your leg to protect you from the wolf. Somebody needs to thank him for that right there. That don't seem like something good to praise him about, that he'll break your leg. But he will. To keep you from the harm of the wolf. Amen. Hallelujah. So David is confident that the Lord will provide for him abundantly in this life with his goodness and his mercy. Not only that, but I thought about this and it leads me. I'm trying to hurry. But he also cares for his creation.
Yes, he does.
In Matthew chapter 6 and verse 25, listen to this. Therefore I say unto you, take no thought for your life what you shall eat or what you shall drink, nor yet for your body what you shall put on. Is it not life? Is not life more than meat, and the body more than raiment?
Amen.
Behold the fowls of the air.
Yes.
For they sow not, neither do they reap, nor gather into barns. Yet your heavenly Father feedeth them. And I love this right here. Are you not so much better than they are?
Amen.
Wow. Hallelujah. I had one of the children ask me the other day a sobering question, and I had to explain to her how I felt about it. I don't know all about heaven. I can't give all the answers. But she kind of leaned that animals had souls. Animals don't have souls. Did you hear what I said? Animals don't have souls. That's what makes us different. That's the separation point between God's creation. The birds of the air aren't God's children. Yet our God provides for them. Hallelujah. And he cares for his creation. And how much more, Jesus says, does God take care of those that are his children? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God didn't send his son to save a woodpecker or a crow. Did you hear what I said? He didn't send his son to save a woodpecker or a crow. He sent his son to save you and me. But yet he feedeth them. And if he feedeth them, don't you know that he'll feed you? Amen. He clothes them. And if he clothes them, don't you know that he'll put clothes on your back when you need it?
Amen.
My Lord. My goodness.
Amen.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Somebody needs to praise him right there again. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So if you ever become doubtful about God's provision, just look at the rest of creation and you can be confident that God's going to provide for your life. Not only that, but God will provide because he told us to ask. Now I want you to get this. In Matthew chapter 6 and verse 11, but when you pray, use not vain repetitions as the heathen do, for they think that they shall be heard for their much speaking. Be not ye therefore like them, for your Father knoweth what things that you are in need of before you ask. After this manner, pray therefore, pray ye, O Father which is in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done as it is in heaven, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. So what did he tell you to do right there? He told you to ask. Give us this day. Give it to us. Give us this day our daily bread. Wow, that's amazing. First, Jesus said, our Father knows what we need before we ask him. Then he tells us to worship our Father and remember he's holy. Hallowed be thy name. And we pray to that God that will bring the kingdom on earth. Then ask for our daily bread.
Amen.
Ask him. How hard is that? We don't have to go on a pilgrimage or afflict ourselves. We just have to ask our Heavenly Father to provide that what we need each day of our life. And Jesus would not tell us to ask the Father if the Father didn't intend to do what we ask.
Amen.
Amen. Boy, that's good stuff.
Come on, brother.
Yes. My goodness. Praise God. So if He told you to ask, ask. If He didn't mean to do what He said, He wouldn't have told you to ask.
Amen. Amen.
If you've got something good in your life that you need, you know what you need to do? Ask for it.
Amen.
Ask for it. God, I need this in my life. How many are glad tonight that you can ask?
Amen.
Hallelujah. And He's promised blessings. The Bible said in Psalms 31 and 19, "Oh, how great is thy goodness, which thou hast laid up for them that fear thee, which thou hast wrought for them that trust thee, that trust in thee before the sons of men." You see, our Father doesn't simply have a tiny portion of goodness to give us. He has a stored up abundant goodness. Well, glory. For those who fear Him, conditional, and run to Him. So we can be confident that God will provide for us. Notice that God's goodness is abundant. He doesn't give sparingly or cheaply.
Amen.
Brother Terry, did you ever have in your pastoral experience, maybe in your early ministry, where they gave you a pounding? You remember those poundings? A lot of it was good, but a lot of it wasn't nothing more than what they didn't want to eat out of their cabinet. Don't look at me like that. They just cleaned out what they wouldn't eat. Some of you might like hominy, but I don't like hominy. I don't know how much hominy I've seen in those areas of my life. I'll tell you something. Don't ever expect junk from God.
Amen.
Did you hear what I said?
Right.
Don't ever expect anything that but the best when it comes to what God gives you. You need to praise God right there. That God will give you the very best. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Abundant. Hallelujah. Abundant is His supply. He has a compassionate heart. That's why He does it. In Mark chapter 8 and verse 1, the Bible said, "In those days, the multitude being very great, having nothing to eat, Jesus called His disciples unto Him and saith unto them, I have compassion on the multitude, because they have now been with Me 3 days and have nothing to eat. And if I send them away to their own houses, they will faint by the way. For divers of them come from afar." Jesus said He had compassion on the multitude who followed Him for those 3 days. Didn't have anything to eat, and He wouldn't send them away hungry. Jesus demonstrated a Father's heart right there. Our Father cares.
Amen.
About our needs.
Amen,
I'm telling you something. Sometimes we need the compassion of the Father.
Amen.
If you think this message is about you're going to go out now and everything's going to be rosy and everything's going to be hunky-dory and everything's going to just fall in place, you got the wrong message.
That's it.
Right.
Because sometimes we get down to where we wonder where it's going to come from.
Amen.
Come on. That's it. Amen.
Has anybody ever been there?
Yes, sir.
You got down to where you wondered where it was going to come from. You wondered where the compassion was from the people. It didn't come. But God looked down and said, "I'll have compassion on you."
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes,
I don't know how many times that we've been down to literally nothing. Literally nothing to eat. I wished I could have played it. I know that Chris sent me a video here a few weeks ago, and I watched it. It's kind of a funny little video about the woman who was praying for God to supply her groceries. I believe she was out of groceries. And her next door neighbor was an atheist, didn't believe in God. But every night she'd say, "Oh God, have compassion on me. I need some groceries." That man got tired of hearing it. And the story says that that man went down and brought a load of groceries and set them on that woman's front porch. He walked over there to her house and she was praising God for the groceries. He said, Don't you know, ma'am, that God didn't give you those groceries? I went and bought you those groceries." She said, "Hallelujah!
Come on.
That God can use even the devil to bring my groceries and set them on my front porch. Amen. Hallelujah!
Amen.
Hallelujah.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He won't withhold any good thing from us.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I don't know if you needed that tonight, but I needed that.
Amen.
That God won't hold any good thing from me. If I walk uprightly, God won't withhold any good thing from me. And lastly, I've got to do this before Lisa comes. He never fails to keep his word. God told Israel he would bring them out of Egypt, conquer all their enemies, and give them the promised land. And in Joshua 21, it says that God fulfilled that word. It says this in verse 44, "And the Lord gave them the rest round about, according to all that he sware unto their father, and there stood not a man of all their enemies before them. The Lord delivered them from their enemies into their land. There failed not aught of any good thing which the Lord had spoken unto the house of Israel. All came to pass."
Amen.
Oh my goodness.
Hallelujah.
Terry, we're so short of what God wants to do for us.
Amen.
We're just so behind.
Yeah,
we've let those prosperity preachers rob us from a blessing.
Sure,
rob us from a blessing that God wants to do in our lives. Rob us. I want to tell you, if the word didn't say that he wanted you to prosper and be in health, he wouldn't have put it in there.
That's right.
Hallelujah. If he didn't say that he wants you to be the head and not the
tail,
he wouldn't have put it in there. And if he didn't say he didn't want you to be the borrower, but the
lender.
Do what?
He wanted us to pay the lender.
He wanted you to have enough money
to lend.
To lend. Did you hear what I just said? If that wasn't true, Sister Lisa, he would have never put that in the book.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
That's right.
So yes, he wants me to prosper.
Yes, he does.
Yet, but it also goes on to this, even as your soul prospers.
There you go, brother.
There's the key.
Amen.
I'm telling you, the Word of God's conditional.
Conditional.
It's a conditional book. If you do what it says, every promise in the book is mine. Hallelujah. If you do what the Word of God says, every promise in the book is yours. You can claim every part of the book. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Would you stand up with me tonight? And I want you to give God praise before even we do anything else tonight, that God is saying, "I will not withhold any good thing. I will not withhold any good thing." I will not withhold any good thing. From those who walk uprightly. Won't you search your heart right now? Won't you raise your hand and search your heart and say, "God, I want to make sure that I'm walking uprightly. That I'm walking in the footsteps of the Word of God. That I'm following what you would have in my life." Hallelujah. 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 Do it again. Pray that prayer. Really pray that prayer. "Lord, search me. Make sure there's not anything that would keep me from receiving the word. Because I need you, God. I need you, God." My office this afternoon, came back pretty early and got in my office. And God just spoke to my heart to tell you that if you walk uprightly before Him, He will not withhold any good thing. Good thing from you. Whether that be financial, whether that be healing for your body, salvation for your family, relationships restored, He will not withhold any good. Any of that's good things, isn't it? Is it a good thing that God financially bless you? That's a good thing. Save your family and restore relationships. I don't know what your good thing is tonight that you need, but God just told me to tell you, don't wait to come here to thank Him for it. Don't wait like the Israelites and wait till you cross before you praise Him. Praise Him on this side. Praise Him now. I wish you'd come to this altar tonight praising Him for the good thing that He's going to give you that you know that you need in your life. Would you come tonight? Would you come to this altar thanking Him? Hallelujah. Thank Him already. Praise Him already. Praise Him already. Hallelujah. Praise Him. Praise Him for those good things. All my life you have been. Come on in here. Come on. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
All my
hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Your goodness is running after. It's running after me. Your goodness is running after. It's running after me. Lay down, I'm surrendered now. You everything. Your goodness is running after. You're running after me.
I want you to do this with me tonight. Listen to me. Listen to me. I want you to think of the greatest need of your life. The most good thing that you need. That you can't get from the world. You can't get from people. But the most important good thing of your life. And I want you to raise your hand and ask Him for it right now. Ask Him for it right now. Ask Him for it right now. I said ask Him for it right now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now I want you to do this with me. Did you ask Him? Are you walking uprightly? Are you walking uprightly before Him? Now I want you to do this. I want you to claim the word. You've asked Him. I want you to say this out loud. Lord, you said you would not withhold any good thing from my life that you know that I need. And I'm going to praise you for it right now. I wish you praise Him out loud. That God is going to fulfill His word.